Here he comes.
Hey, Gani. Yes, boss. You know this COVID thing? It's kind of got me very nervous. So I came up with a plan. In order to detect potential COVID problem in this office, I came up with a form. So every employee from today onwards, before they come to work, they have to fill up the form. Before they go to the toilet, they have to fill up the form. Before they go for lunch, they have to fill up the form. When they come back from lunch, they have to fill up the form. And they have to fill up the form before they leave. Where's the form? It's in your email. Would you check your emails? This form has about 20 word questions. It's going to take me half an hour just to fill up this form.
Yes.
But it is necessary. So I want you to start filling up this form. And I will check on you. If you don't fill up this form, you are fired.
It's almost lunchtime now. I wonder if he's filling in the form. Doesn't look like it. It's gonna be fired today.
Oh, it's lunchtime. Ah, gotta fill up the stupid form. Hey, where do you think you are going? Lunchtime, boss. Let's eat. Hungry. What did I say to you this morning? Have you filled up the form? I've been watching you and I don't think you have filled up the form. I did fill up the form. If you don't believe me, go and check out. Check out whether I've actually filled it. But I'm going to lunch right now. Bye, boss. Without you. Hey, where do you think you're going? I'm pretty sure he didn't fill up the form. Let me check. I got him this time. He actually filled up the form. I was watching him. I'm pretty sure he didn't fill up the form. How did he do this? It's not really a mystery. It's basically a very simple tool. Let me show you over the PC. I just hope my dumb boss is not around. I don't want him to know.
As you can see here, my boss has created this wonderful form that I have to fill in every day. So I'm not going to fill in this form. So the trick here is to install a Chrome extension called Autofill. Now, as the extension name says, the purpose of it is to autofill any forms. And the example here is actually a Google form that I need to fill in. But it doesn't need to work on Google form. It can work on any form. As long as there is a fields, there is a form base, it should work. Now, how do we, first step, how do we get this autofill extension? So it works on Chrome and it works on Edge. So I'm using an Edge browser. All I need to do is do a search called autofill Chrome. There you go. It should be the first result. Click on it. It should bring you to the Chrome Web Store. It will work on Edge as well. So you do add to Chrome. And I'm using an Edge browser right now. Autofill has been added. Okay, great. So that's done. And in order for it to work, it's actually here as a lightning icon, a symbol. In order for it to work, you just need to refresh this page and it will be now enabled. It's highlighted. So to run this to fill in this form automatically, the first thing you need to do is click on this and there'll be bar popping up. So we need to fill in the form and then it will start to capture all those answers in this form and will auto fill the next round. So just have to do it for one time only. So your temperature this morning, 36.4, I don't care. Do you have a cough? No. What's your temperature after the toilet? So this is the type of boss that I have. I'm going to put in 36. So any of the following medication, Panadol, H2 is water, LSD, no, I don't do drugs. 1+2, I don't know. So once you have done this, all you need to do is click on generate auto rules. You can create a profile, but I'm not going to do it here. So just generate auto rules and it says done. What it means by done is here, it has captured the answers that you have placed in this form. In the next round, when you come back to this form, it will pre-fill the exact same answers that you have chosen here. So example, let me just refresh this page, right? There you go. It automatically detects the page and it pre-fills automatically. Now, there's a caveat here. This particular autofill function, when you load the page, it works sometime on Google Form, sometime it doesn't work. So I'm quite lucky to be able to capture this on the first round. So let me reload again. As you can see here, it did not manage to reload, right? So this is a bit wonky on Google Form in particular. But if this case happens, no worries. What you need to do is just click on the lightning icon. Right-click on the right icon. Execute profile. And you can choose your profile. In this case, I was unfiled. And you can see that it's pre-filled automatically. So it only takes less than a second. It's that fast. So if you have a very long form and the form is consistent, this tool is a major help, especially for kids at school who needs to sign in every day online to make sure your attendance, or parents who needs to sign in for kids online, or even adults who needs to go to the work and you have forms that you need to fill in every single day, you can use this tool. It's a lifesaver. Now, this tool is actually quite powerful, and let's go and see. So you right-click on the icon and go to extension option. So this is the back end of it. So what happened earlier was, this is the fields that it detected, and this was the answer that you have put in. And it works quite powerful on JavaScript. So if you know JavaScript, you can do a lot of stuff here, because not only text, checkbox, password, it also supports JavaScript code in this particular field here. Another good thing that it's able to support is variable. And for instance, we had the feel here earlier, right? The temperature. So if my boss is going to see me having 36.4 every day, he's going to get a bit suspicious. So what we can do, we can randomize the temperature. And we can use this by using a JavaScript code. So let me pull out my code. So what you can do is we can use this particular code, paste it here. So this is the variable name, and this is the JavaScript to randomize between 35 to 30. Okay, so we save this code. Now, how do we execute? How do we call these variables? You can see the example is given here. Curly bracket and the variable name. So let's say this is 36.4. I'm going to copy the variable name here. And this is 36.4. I'm going to put a curly bracket. I need to put an alias in front and close curly bracket. And I'm going to save this. So let's go back to the form. So initially it saved as 36.4, right? So let's reload this page. And you can see the number has changed to 30. And ironically, it's able to pre-fill automatically without me executing it. So that's how powerful this particular, and there's a lot more on the back end that you can do. There are advanced features, exceptions, we support regular expressions. There are variables that I just showed you. And in terms of, there are other things that I have not explored personally, like fuzzy logic and fuzzy label matching and all that, all right. So, but it serves my purpose enough. So that's how I managed to fill my form quickly every day. And if you have similar needs, go ahead and follow the instructions that I gave you. So don't forget to like and subscribe. And I hope this video will be helpful. See you all again. Bye.